Okay guys, so we got a VW here. It's a 1600. This engine has been bored and stroked. And so I just wanted to show you the ring gap on this real quick. I took off the top compression ring here, and you need to do the second compression ring. You don't have to do the oil ring, but the first and second one you do, the two compression rings. So we're just gonna set it down inside this sleeve. And then I'm gonna push my piston down just to make sure that it's square. I'll just set it down on the next compression ring. Now you look in there, you'll see there's a small gap there where the ring meets each other. Now, VW manufacturer says this needs to be 16 to 18 thousandths, which it is. That's for a standard 1600 engine. Now, because we're gonna run turbo on this, we have to gap this bigger. It needs to be at 20 thousandths. And you can see that won't even go in there. So I need to pull this ring out and I need to file it down and put it back in and check it again. Just do a little bit each time till you reach 20 thousandths if you're gonna run a turbo. The reason is because those will build so much pressure, they'll literally pop the top right off the piston, I've heard. So we're only gonna do the first and second compression rings on every single cylinder, all four cylinders. And this is gonna keep it from building too much pressure, like I said, getting too hot and causing damage to your engine. So you want that to be at 20 thousandths. Now, if you are 16 to 18 thousandths and you're building it stock, once again, that's fine. So I hope this video helps you out. Please click like, please click subscribe, click on my name underneath this video for all my other how-to videos. And as always, guys, enjoy.